Hello, everyone. Have I got something for you today? Something extra rare, extra special, and extra shitty. I haven't gotten the chance to stream many weird games thus far, but today I have something that I've had for a very long time and that I've been meaning to been meaning to share just because of how awful it is. And I finally got the chance, and I want to do it before I eventually get a new computer, because it took a lot of work to get it running on this one, and I don't want to have to try to get it running on a new one, which will be even harder, because this is something that was designed for Windows 95, I think. 95, 98, I think it runs on, and it does not like to run on anything later than those. So there were a lot of struggles to get this working. I finally managed to get it done, and I'm gonna have to use a monitor capture for this one, so it will be a little not ideal. Hopefully it doesn't drop any extra frames or anything. I am going to be streaming Pokémon Play It, which was a launch disc that came with the Pokémon Trading Card Game when the trading card game was first created and released. To, you know, it was one of those things that was supposed to teach people how to play the game, and you can see the production values in action. They give me a second. I'm gonna just go ahead and start it up right here, this fabulous Windows 95 software. I am not gonna be able to see the chat in this one because it is full screen, and there's no other way to do this game. Makers of fine, fine software, I'm sure. It's not noon, it's 3:30.
Hey, my name is Julie. I'm a Pokemon.
I'm doing it.
Oh my god. That is as horrible as I remember.
Trainer, just like you.
It's beautiful.
Stick with me, and together.
Just like the Pokemon anime, it looks so perfect. When are we gonna get a claymation Pokemon series? That's happening, right?
But you can do more than just collect and trade these cards.
Oh, those kids are so beautiful.
Using the cards.
Yeah, that's like Ash Ketchum.
Against your friends to become the best there ever was.
Oh, look at that mouth.
So, do you have what it takes? Then let's go.
Yeah, let's go. It's amazing. They're doing a I kind of off topic, they're doing a new Yu-Gi-Oh! Animated thing with Yugi and Kaiba.
Pokemon Play It. Type in your name, and then
yeah, like
okay.
A special.
Or select your name from the list. See you in the arena.
Yeah, it's kind of cool it's happening, but it looked. I don't know, I looked at it and the eyes looked so weird, like they forgot how to draw Yugi's eyes. Not as bad as this, mind you, but. Yeah? Is that what happened? Yeah. It took a lot of doing to get it working. Alright. Well, this is actually a short enough game that I'm going to try to get through it in a single sitting. I don't plan on doing two streams of this, so we'll see how long this takes. Well, there are a couple other features to this game, but I'm gonna start with just, you know, the plain old going through the thing. What do you what I forget what Judy was her name?
Welcome to my gymnasium. We'll play
Okay.
through a lot of tough games while we're here. Click on the first Pokemon there, and we'll get started.
Okay, the voice acting isn't abysmal. The voice acting is not terrible. It's actually, honestly, it's better than the Pokemon anime. But oh my god, that animation.
Hey, this is the playing field. It's where our Pokemon fight. Welcome. I'm ready for you. Let's battle.
Okay.
Staryu, I choose you.
I take back what I said about the voice acting.
Hey, see those cards down there at the bottom of the screen? Those are the cards in your hand. And see this card here? That's Machop, your active Pokemon.
Oh, okay.
Machop
I've,
and
I've never
Staryu
I've never
are
played
in
this
the
before.
arena.
I'll have to learn
the arena
things.
Is where Pokemon fight. Remember that, okay? And any Pokemon in the arena is called an active Pokemon.
I actually have played the Pokemon Trading Card Game before.
On to the play. In a real game,
this was the first version I played. I also played the Game Boy version and the online, but I haven't really stuck to that, so.
I'll go first. First thing you do on your turn, draw a card. So, that's what I'm going to do now.
Prepare for lots of... Oh, Julie, that's it, not Judy.
On to Staryu. With one water energy, Staryu has enough to use its slap attack now. Oh yeah, before you get crushed with the slap attack, listen up. Put your cursor on top of Staryu and check it out. Good. If you want to learn,
you know what? This is a better
Pokemon
interface than X-Mage.
Go over to the main menu and click on her. See the big card on the right? That's how you can tell what each card says. And the attack information for Staryu is just below that. Now, for the slap attack. Staryu, go!
Again, I cannot cheat, see the I cannot see the chat for any of you tuning in. This is full screen and I can't do it any other way.
There's a bunch of counters in the box of cards you bought. Use them in the same way when you play the real game.
Wait for her to shut up so I can talk.
50 hit points and took 20 hit points of damage. So now it has 30 points left. If a Pokemon reaches 0 hit points, it's lights out. It's knocked out. And out of the arena it would go into the discard pile. All right, it's your turn. What's the first thing you do?
Floor it. I floor it, right? That's the first thing I do. So, for those of you, if there's anyone just tuning in,
draw a card.
Shut up. This is the launch disc that came with the Pokémon Trading Card Game when it was first released in the 90s, made to work on Windows 95. And I got Shut up. I managed to get it working on this computer with a lot of work, and I wanted to stream it before I inevitably got a new computer at some point, because I didn't want to try and get it working on another one all over. God damn it, Julie!
Right, draw a card. All right, what's next?
I drew a fucking card, are you happy?
Energy to Machop.
Hey, draw a card!
To Machop.
Okay, fine, I'll give... Huh? I'm trying to do the thing, what? Play a card. Oh, I have to drag it. Okay.
Right.
I can't just click
now
it.
Machop can attack.
Not like X-Mage.
Go ahead. You can't hurt me. Click on the attack button.
Attack. I can't hurt her, she says.
Oh, 20 points done to Staryu. It has 20 left. You know, if your Pokemon had more than one attack, you'd get to choose which one to use.
Oh, is that how that works?
The Machop only has one attack, the low kick. So it will use that one all the time. Now it's my turn.
That doesn't seem right. It's skipping. Someone's gonna make a sick remix out of this. Is it gonna resolve? Okay, I'm gonna try changing windows and coming back. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try to do that. Okay, I'm gonna launch the task manager. Uh-oh, not responding, it says. That's not good. Okay, I might have to actually start this over. That's not good. Well, sorry about that. Now I'll get to see the chat. Well, okay, gonna try to start that over one more time. Let's do the tutorial again! Sorry I can't keep up with your chat, Mr. Donut. Well, you're up, either up really early or really late for Australia. Well, at least this time I can skip this shit. Okay.
Hi.
All right. That's okay.
Hey,
I think.
This is the. Hey.
Oh yeah. Okay. I can click on
her
to
the screen,
skip
those
things.
Those are the cards in your hand. And see this card here.
Okay.
That's
yes,
Machop,
I see the card.
Your active Pokemon, Machop and Staryu are in the arena. The arena is where Pokemon.
I know what the arena is. Let me play the fucking game.
And any Pokemon in the arena is called an active Pokemon.
Okay.
You got
active
that?
Pokemon.
Good. Okay. On to the fighting. In a real game, there's a lot more to getting
22
ready.
22 card
and
deck,
we'll learn
yeah,
that
real
later.
Game.
For now, let's see how the Pokemon battle one another.
Okay, yeah, let's do that.
I'll go first.
Oh.
First thing you do on your turn, draw a card. So, that's what I'm going to do now.
Quick time battles, the game.
Now, I'm gonna attach a water energy onto Staryu.
Okay, let's go. Okay, you did your energy
With
thing.
One
you
water
energized.
Energy, Staryu has enough to use its slap attack now.
Okay, my
oh,
cursor's
yeah.
on it.
Before you get crushed with the slap attack, listen up. Put your cursor on top of Staryu and check it out. Good. If you want to learn more
oh, okay.
about Pokemon cards, go over
That's
to
actually
the
a good
menu,
piece of programming. It recognized
help,
it was on the cursor immediately. I didn't
right?
have to like move
That's
it off and
how you
on
can
again.
Tell what each card says. And the attack information for Staryu is just below that. Now, for the slap attack.
Okay.
Staryu, go!
I mean, we weren't too far into the game, so that's a better time for it to crash than any other time. I've never actually had
Those
this disc crash before.
Indicate the damage
it's still in a, it's in really good
one
shape, so
10 points.
I wonder if that might
There's
have had to do with
in
like the fact that I'm streaming
on.
As well, too much
use
system
them in
use,
the same
I don't
way
know.
When you play the real
I guess
game.
I could close out of Steam
Machop
if I had
started
to.
With 50 hit points and took 20 hit points of damage. So now it has 30 points left.
I might be streaming for a little while today. Depends on
points. It's lights out.
Depends on
it's
what I
out.
Might feel like doing. I have a whole free day
go.
Today, so
into the discard pile.
I don't know. Maybe I'll go to some Spelunky or
All
something
right,
after this.
It's
we'll
your
see.
Turn.
And
What's
planning hopefully some
do?
Awesome knots tonight. Okay,
right.
I drew a card.
Draw a card. All right. What's next? You need to assign some enemies.
Let me drag the thing. I want to drag the thing to the thing. There we go.
Now Machop can attack.
There we go. Okay, we're back to where we were.
Oh, 20 points done to Staryu. It has 20 left.
Okay,
you know,
I can do
your
simple
Pokemon
math.
If had more than one attack, you'd get to choose which one to use. But Machop only has one attack, the low kick. So it will use that one all the time. Now it's my turn. Let's see. Draw a card.
Okay, we're good. We're past the that
Don't
point.
Don't need that. I need a potion.
Well, you're not getting a potion.
I guess I'll attack. Staryu, go!
Yeah, you listen to her voice. You know she's lost. She knows she's lost.
Look out! Machop is down to 10 hit points. Since my attack is done, my turn is ended. It's your
yeah,
turn
look
now.
Out my
Don't
foot.
Don't forget to draw a card.
Oh, yeah, interesting card. Just because I can. I could retreat. No, I can't retreat, because then I wouldn't have an active
hey,
Pokemon.
Take Oh, better than I thought. You knocked out Staryu.
Nice effect there.
When you knock out a Pokemon in play, it goes into the discard pile, and then you get to draw a prize card. Do that now. Draw a prize card from your pile.
Sent to the graveyard.
Well, congratulations.
Oh, great. I get yes. something that.
If you
something cool just in time for me to not be able to use it.
You win. This was only practice, so it doesn't count against me. All right. You won the first battle. Let's go back and
okay,
play
it was
another
just a
game.
Warm-up.
Click on the return button. You won a badge. Good job. Collect all the badges, and you'll get the trophy.
Okay, that's a lot of badges for Pokemon. What happened to there being only 8? Wasn't that a thing? Maybe I should stream the Pokémon Trading Card Game on Game Boy. Was it Game Boy or Game Boy Color? I think it was Game Boy.
Hey! Can you hear me?
No.
I can't see you. Oh, that's better. So, let's go over how to begin a game. There's a couple of important steps we need to go over.
So where's the porn of her? She's got to be in high demand on Rule 34. Everyone's hankering for Julie, right?
Game and the card game you bought. So listen up. First thing you do when you start a new game, shuffle your deck. Since the computer is so cool, it'll do it for us. Watch.
This new age thing called the computer.
Okay, next thing you do.
It's so awesome. It does all these things. Who would have thought a machine could do all these things, like shuffle cards?
Click on your deck to draw 7 cards.
There we go. Okay.
Good. I'll draw 7 cards too.
I'm going to try to make my responses pretty prompt to minimize the amount of time we're spending here.
Don't let your opponent see the cards in your hand. Don't lay them on the table, silly.
Now, pick
one Pokemon from your hand.
Sorry, I didn't realize my digital cards were laid on the table.
That's the one that goes into battle in the arena.
Oh, I have to drag it, right.
Okay, that's good.
It's more interactive than simply clicking.
Did you notice how that Pokemon went into the arena face down? Well, you're supposed to do that at the beginning of the game, so I don't see your choice. I'm gonna play my Pokemon, too. I'm sure I'll win. Let's play for one prize, okay? That means the first one to knock out a Pokemon wins. Normally, we play for 3 prizes, but we'll keep the game simple for now.
It's not much in terms of replay value, but it gets the job done as a tutorial. It does what it's supposed to do.
Okay, now,
teaches kids how to play the game.
To see who goes first.
Okay, let's flip the Pikachu coin.
I go first. Heads, you go first. Heads, you go first. So, the last thing we do is turn all the Pokemon cards over.
I think
get the computer to do that.
In the Game Boy version,
excellent.
You could actually time the coin flip
Goldeen
to more consistently get what you wanted. Whereas in this game, it's actually random. Okay. Not giving me instructions. I can actually just go ahead and do things. I think I'm getting the hang of this. I guess I could have put an energy card on just to clear some space in my hand. I forget what the limit on hand size in Pokemon is,
or
if there's
a
limit.
Are you sure you want to put more energy on that Pokemon?
Yes.
It doesn't seem to need that much.
Shut up!
Whatever. It's your game, not mine.
Yeah, that's right, it is. God damn it, Julie. Backseat playing. Well, now this is just a slugfest.
Are you sure you want to put more energy on that Pokemon?
Don't question me, Julie!
Oh man, I lost. Well, good job. Click on the return button.
So the whole point of that was just to show how to, like, get a game started, and after that it was all busy work.
It's a brand new game. This time, I'm using a lightning deck. I'm sure to win this time.
Okay.
Let's get things started. Click on your deck to draw 7 cards.
She shared with me her strategy. Now I can coordinate against it by, like, building a fighting deck. Which I'm sure I've done, right? Oh, no. Okay. No, I just built an everything deck.
Hey, you need to select your active Pokemon and place it in the arena. Let's play for one prize again, okay?
Okay. That seems to have been working out for you historically, so let's continue.
Flip the coin, and we'll see who goes first. Heads. Shoot.
I go first.
You get to go first. Voltorb versus Growlithe, eh? You don't stand a chance.
Okay. But she's a cocky son of a bitch, isn't she?
Okay.
She's like...
Try playing a grass energy on Growlithe.
How do you know I've got grass energy?
See what happens. Hey, you know what? The grass energy counts as the needed white energy. The white energy is called colorless.
Oh, is that what that is?
Put your cursor on top of Growlithe, and I'll show you what I mean.
I'm gonna guess I'm gonna get a fire energy next turn.
See this symbol here? It stands for colorless energy. Any energy card can act as colorless. Growlithe needs one fire energy, and one energy of any kind, to use the flare attack. You can't attack yet because Growlithe only has one energy on it. Take a closer look. The attack for Growlithe, flare,
fucking triggered
an
explanation.
Wait until next turn to assign another energy.
What'd she say if I try to run?
You can't retreat because there's no other Pokemon on your bench.
What's a bench? You haven't explained that yet. You're getting ahead of yourself. Okay, now you bzzzed me. Now I get a fire energy. And I can
Good.
Do things.
With a fire energy attached, Growlithe has enough energy to attack.
Yeah, what was that? I don't stand a chance. Which is like a one of the players from the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime. Where just everyone is just an incredibly cocky fuck.
Hey, good play. Now Growlithe is feeling better. That potion is a trainer card. To learn more about trainer cards, you can always go back to the main menu and click on the help button.
Okay. I'm assuming that that would be in a future lesson, that I wasn't supposed to know that yet as well. At least these are going by quickly. Crashing aside.
Oh, good job. You win. Don't forget to draw that prize card.
This game does save automatically. So even if it does, God forbid, crash again, we'd be deprived of this glorious piece of software.
Click on the return button.
I should be able to come back and pick up where I left off. Wow, some computers are super neato! Where are you, Julie? Oh, there she is.
Ready to go again?
All
no. Right. Let's go for one prize again. Keep it simple.
Okay. Most of these are tutorials, and then
Remember,
I think...
Remember, when playing with real cards, don't let your opponent see the cards in your hand. Don't lay them on the table, see?
I think the advanced challenge, that big trophy in the bottom right of the previous menu, is the only one that's like an actual game that you can run the risk of losing if you don't follow simple instructions. Well, I mean, you only risk losing if you don't follow simple instructions in most of these, because they're just tutorials, but...
Dratini versus Mudkip.
That's the only one that's an actual game that you can, you know, conceivably win or lose.
And check this out. See these red boxes? That's my bench. I can put up to 5 Pokemon there. It's
we're learning
Pokemon
about the bench
in
now.
In case Dratini takes too much damage and has to chicken out. So I'll take Staryu from my hand and put it on my bench.
How come I don't get any Pokemon
now
in
I'm gonna
the
play
bench?
My one energy.
I don't have anyone to put on
and
the bench.
And now, I can attack.
Aww. I'm a bad trainer. I'm like a gym leader who doesn't have a full party of 6 Pokemon.
You know, if you have any Pokemon in your hand, I'd play the
Rainbow Hitmonchan.
But that's the only hint I'm gonna give.
That is the signifier of an extra fabulous Pokemon card. Oh, he's dragon, so he's not weak to fighting. All right, whatever.
Oh, Dratini's hurt pretty bad. So I think I'll retreat and bring in Staryu. Put your cursor on top of Dratini. See the symbol in the lower right of the card? Dratini has to pay one colorless.
I hope you're all finding this educational. I hope you appreciate the things I go through.
While others have to pay up to 3. Anyway, I'm gonna pay the 1 energy to retreat Dratini.
Again, anyone just coming in, I cannot see the chat, so apologies if you're shouting at me or
now
doing anything.
Now Staryu can attack.
Oh no, I'm gonna lose.
Hey, I'd retreat if I were you. Hey, I'd retreat if I were you. Click on the retreat button. Hey, stop cheating.
Aww,
you can only play one energy card per turn. If you need to, go back to the help menu and learn more about energy.
Don't insult me.
Okay, so you're going to retreat, huh? Pay the retreat cost by clicking on the right amount of energy attached to the active Pokemon. Good. Now drag Machop onto Hitmonchan. Machop retreated, and Hitmonchan came into battle. Good move.
I've really been in a Paper Mario mood of late. Sadly, Jack has been too busy to do any streaming, but I really want to jump back on that again soon. Okay, now I can cheat.
Hey, stop cheating.
Oh, fine. Yeah, that's what a jab looks like, flying rocks.
Oh man, Staryu's getting destroyed. Lucky for me, I have a potion trainer card I can play. Check it out. Trainer cards are a lifesaver sometimes. You can play as many as you want during your turn. Just read them to figure out what they do. Each one is different.
I got slapped. Okay, I'll do this.
Good play.
Shut up.
See how powerful a trainer card can be?
I don't need your patronizing. Okay, and then I'm gonna wait. I'm not gonna attack you just yet. I'm gonna bide
wait,
my
you
time.
You should have attacked.
No,
your
shut up.
Pokemon had enough energy.
You don't how tell me you? How to beat you. You just lie back and you take it. That sounded really bad, didn't it? There we go. Okay, you gonna get destroyed. One Punch Man, Hitmonchan. I noticed she's she's notoriously silent after criticizing me for not attacking the previous turn.
Oh, you won. I guess Hitmonchan was just too tough. Click on the return button to go back to the gymnasium.
It's far too fabulous for you. Speaking of fabulous Pokemon. Okay, last basic one. I don't remember how many of them are. They gotta be all. I think they're all tutorials, to some degree. I think there's a little more risk involved as it goes on, though.
But this game's gonna be tough for sure. One prize up for grabs. Remember, most games play for 3 or even 6 prizes, but we're just practicing.
Oh, I don't think I'm ready for that. I'm not a tournament player. Why don't I play the Pokémon Trading Card Game online? Well, the answer is very simple. It's because that game is balanced. I couldn't say that with a straight face. It really is. I kind of want to play the Game Boy version because I found a way to kind of break it. And it's fun to find ways to break games, especially old games.
I think I'm gonna win.
But, no, for the online version, it's really just a matter of do you happen to be able to get the best cards, the legendaries, the EX cards, whatever the trend is at the moment. And it's just
Nidoran needs to flip a coin.
It's not fun to decide games by
no damage to me this time.
How much you spend on the it's pay to win.
Some Pokemon have special instructions for their attack, like the Horn Hazard for Nidoran. You've got
which
to
is
read
a,
them.
An element in a lot of trading card games is any
I've
physical trading
Growlithe
card games.
In
that's
my
how
hand.
They make the money
so
is by
put it on the
selling
bench.
The best cards. So I tend to stick to digital versions of said games if I play them at all. Oh, I could have, I guess I could have put him out anytime.
Hmm.
I've always been kind of bothered that
take a look at this cool move.
Nidoran male and female were not combined into a single creature in Gen 2 when genders came to be.
Like Growlithe, it evolves into Arcanine. I could have evolved my active Pokemon, but I wanted to evolve the one on my bench. Either choice is legal. Now, take a look at Arcanine closely.
I guess it makes sense. It's not like there's not a precedent. Like, Miltank is the female version of Tauros. They're technically the same species.
See what it says there in the upper left corner? It tells you that Arcanine evolves from Growlithe, and that Arcanine is a Stage 1 Pokemon. Evolved, or Stage 1 Pokemon, are stronger and tougher than the basic Pokemon out there. They're great in battle.
Oh, is that how that works? I thought evolving a Pokemon would make it weaker. Silly me.
Whoa, Nidoran is looking pretty weak. You might play your potion card on it.
Don't
when
you
it's
call
your turn.
My Pokemon weak. Yeah, I'll wait just a second on him. I want to be able to attack this turn. See, now there's at least a little variance going on. I'm having some choice here.
Whoa, Nidoran is looking pretty weak. You might play your potion card on it when it's your turn.
How do you know what cards I... She blames me for cheating, and then she's looking at my hand the whole game long. What a bitch.
Nidoran evolved.
Hey, the dying whale from Paper Mario
really
is back.
The game really gets going when evolved Pokemon battle each other.
You know what really gets the game going is when an evolved Pokemon whips the ass of a non-evolved Pokemon. Let's see what happens then. I wonder if I'd kept my... I just won anyway. I was gonna say, I wonder if I kept my Nidoran out one more turn. Then she would not have switched, and I would have been able to use Horn Drill to just one-shot the Growlithe. But I one-shotted it anyway.
Oh man, you won! Good move when you evolve Nidoran. I wonder what the Nidorino. All right,
I wonder if that rainbow thing is supposed to signify
click on the return button.
Hollow cards. Maybe that's what it's supposed to be.
Congratulations. You got the first 5 badges. You're a great trainer.
Well, thank you for finally realizing it.
Play some Pokemon.
Face.
Make sure you check the text box at the top and the bottom
it's
of
so
the screen.
It's so beautiful.
And do what it tells
so amazing.
You.
Those
Ready?
Eyebrows,
Let's
everything.
Play.
The hair strands on top. Looks like someone, a kid playing with Play-Doh, just grabbed them and stretched out little tiny tentacles in every direction. Oh, what do I want? Does it matter? That's 30 hit points. I'm gonna want to attack on the first turn, I think. Okay, we're finally getting to 3 card games. Now this is gonna be some tournament play you're gonna see right here. Yeah. Okay. Take out your Goldeen. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna lose my Diglett for it on the turn immediately after.
Didn't hurt at all. Let's see.
But that's okay. Xelrog the Marcher returns.
I should get some Pokemon on the bench just to get them ready for battle.
Okay. Oh, that was a bad run of Awesome Knots we had last night. I really want to redeem that.
Come on, heads!
Oh, no, come on, tails! Oh, damn it.
Let's see. I can play one energy.
Oh, she can. She pulls from her deck. I thought it was like she was switching with someone on the bench.
I think I'll retreat.
Oh, it has no retreat cost. That sucks. What? Ooh. That was a weird noise.
Pokemon has enough energy, and I've done everything else I want to do. So.
Oh, she's going to attack.
Yes.
Oh, I want a Dugtrio. It's probably not what I'm supposed to be doing, but I'm going to keep doing it anyway. It's going to evolve, and I don't remember how much. Oh, maybe Seeking has 60. Maybe I can take him out.
Check this out.
Oh, 70. Just had to be one more. And he's going to... Yep, he's going to take me out. Oh, I lost it. Julie. Of all people. There goes my energy cards.
Knocked out of the arena.
There's actually a chance I could lose this one. If I just keep getting nothing but energy cards. I got two turns.
Let's see. Draw a card.
Should have put the Meowth out first. Down, 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 down. Is it happening again? Am I gonna get a second chance? Was I saved from the battle? I think we lost it. Well, there goes another one. Oh well, can't be helped. No one's fault. Absolutely random chance. Okay, get over here. Task manager, please. There we go. Well, that sure was unfortunate. Oh, that was going so well for her, too. I feel bad, almost, kinda. Well, only thing we can do is try again. Boy, this game is really touchy to resource usage. Despite it being made for Windows 95, and thus being made to run on, what, how many megabytes of RAM... Every time. Nope. Hi, nothing, Julie. Imagine if this game didn't save automatically.
Make sure you check the text box at the top and the bottom of the screen and do what it tells you.
If it didn't save automatically, then you'd never see it all, because I'd have stopped by now. Okay, draw my 7 cards. I'm on to... Oh, I got a different hand. Interesting. So there's actually randomization here. It's not actually just scripted like the previous ones. This is an actual card game. Okay, who do I want? I'm gonna go with Machop for the first one this time. Okay, there's some randomization here. What is wrong with me? I'm glad there's RNG. Though I guess in a card game it kind of has to be, or otherwise there's no game.
Huh, don't need that. I should get some Pokemon on the bench, just to get them ready for battle.
It feels like I'm playing with a real person.
I'm gonna play a trainer card. Come on, heads!
Oh. She always starts with that, though. Okay, it failed. Good.
Let's see. I can play one energy card per turn, so... my active Pokemon has enough energy. And I've done everything else I want to do, so...
She really likes to hear herself talk.
Oh, yes!
Sure, fuck it, 2 Diglets. I just need one more and I'll have a Dugtrio.
I'll live.
For now. Okay, and that has a retreat cost, so I'm feeling better about that, Staryu.
Out of here. Gotta pay the retreat cost first.
Oh, goddammit. Don't do that.
Seal.
Oh, this is amazing.
Cool.
Oh, that's good. That's a good thing for me to have gotten. Those are kind of crappy moves, though. Like, if I evolve him into Machoke, I'm not going to be able to do anything in terms of damage. So I'm going to have to... Maybe I should have just retreated. Shit. Can I take that back? No, I can't take back moves. God damn it. Alright. I'll keep going. If it gets to be... I think I'll probably retreat him next turn.
I'm gonna play a trainer card.
No, don't do that. Fuck you, Bill.
My active Pokemon has enough energy, and I've done everything else I want to do.
Yeah, so... give me your worst.
Yes!
Okay. Yay, Dugtrio! Can I evolve them now? How's this work? I should have a Dugtrio by all rights, right? This is how this works? I guess I should retreat. Diglets have no retreat cost, so I can just do whatever I want with them. Yeah, I'm gonna... That Karate Chop is about to do no damage if I put it out, so... There's really no point in that. Oh, don't freeze.
Okay, so drag your active Pokemon on top of one of your benched Pokemon. That will complete the retreat and make them switch.
And might as well. Okay. Now I can do the thing. I'm gonna do the thing. And the next turn I can kill the seal. If it doesn't evolve. It better not evolve.
Huh, that didn't hurt at all.
Well, I'm actually having to try now, to some extent.
I should get some Pokemon on the bench, just to get them ready for battle.
It's like it's actually a game, guys.
The active Pokemon is out of here. Gotta pay
the retreat. Oh, don't do that! Stop doing that! Let me kill one of them! You're such a pussy. I guess I should keep doing Machoke. Machoke's only going to be worth if I get a Machamp. Otherwise, I might as well just go with the Diglets. I'm just going to keep Diglett-ing. Diglett-ing, Diglett-ing. Trio. It's a Diglett-ing trio. Oh, this is a high risk investment, though.
Wow.
Because
aha, check this out.
Don't evolve it.
Out.
Are we not gonna get through this? Is this gonna be it? Maybe I will have to do this in two streams. Maybe I'll have to just try to get through the basic ones this time and the advanced ones next time. Okay, I am going to, I'm gonna at least close Steam. So that's one less process running. What else can I close? I guess I could, will AGV let me close it? Or can I only disable it? Where are you, AVG? Yeah, I'm gonna end AVG. Oh, I'm not allowed to close it. Okay. Adobe Desk. I don't need Adobe Desktop Service. I'm having to micromanage my resources to get this thing working. Oh, Firefox has taken a lot, but I do want the chat open. Ah, whatever. I'll try it. I'm gonna try it again. Wish me luck, boys. Still on this one. If I can get through those three basic challenges,
let's play some Pokemon.
We'll see how long the
Make
stream
sure
is gone.
The text box at the top and the bottom of the screen, and do what it
I'd rather
you.
Not have a four-hour video if I can help it, but wow, this game is more crash-prone than I'd ever thought. It did not used to do this though. I've never had this game crash before when playing it without streaming. So. It's just too much to handle. With OBS and everything running. And this is a 5-6-year-old computer.
Let's see. Draw a card.
Which is why I mentioned I do. I've been having some troubles with it since Windows has started their Windows 10 bullshit. And I've had to disable Windows updates, so it's days are numbered. I'm going to have to get a new computer at some point in the probably next year or two. Probably the next year. So
I can play one energy card per turn. So
which is why I wanted to get this out of the way while I had it working and set up on this computer.
Energy, and I've done everything else I want to do. So
there's another game like that I've been wanting to stream for a while. It's on the steamy side, though, so I'm going to have to actually contact Twitch and get it cleared first. Yeah, evolve right away! Bulk up! Oh, I can't do that.
Oh, you can't evolve a Pokemon on your first turn. Wait until next turn.
But I want to evolve it. I could always fiddle with the priorities too. Maybe those would help. That would help.
I'll live.
Now she's gonna retreat it. God, she's got so many Pokemon.
My active Pokemon is out of here. Gotta pay the retreat cost first. So.
She's got so many pathetic Pokemon, and she keeps juggling them.
Oh, yes!
Okay, I'm gonna wait to evolve it until I actually have the energy to attack with Machoke. I'm gonna lose that Machop.
Let's see. Draw a card.
I did see that comment before while the game last crashed, and yes, her hair is indeed a croissant.
Gotta pay the retreat cost first.
Okay,
so.
Bitch out again. She's losing all her energy card, but she's just got so many to juggle.
My active Pokemon.
I hope she gets energy. Hope she gets mana starved.
So.
Okay, that's okay, I can take that hit. Oh, I'm gonna get my Machoke, and then the kill rolls are gonna start.
Knocked out of the arena!
Yeah, shut up. Don't look so proud. Okay, I got a Meowth. Got a Machop, I'm gonna do the thing. Okay, she's out of energy cards. Whatever she does next, she's gonna have to, not gonna be able to retreat this one. Or if she does... Oh, come on! You mother... It's not gonna work. I'm not gonna be able to finish this fight! It's just gonna keep crashing. Well, shit. How long have we even been going for? Task manager, come on. Oh, now the task manager doesn't want to. There we go. Wow, this is just not having any of it. How long have we been going? It's still under an hour. Alright, I'm going to try messing with the resource, with the priority. This might tank the stream. I'm going to set this Windows 95 game to high priority. Also, I'm going to close Elgato, because if I have to forego streaming any console games today, so be it. Oh, crap, no. Okay, I don't want to end OBS. Okay, I wonder if I do have to close the chat. I'm sorry, Donut, I'm going to have to close Firefox. I'm just going to have the chat not open at all, because I want to... Hopefully I can get the video recording for at least YouTube. So I'm going to close the Twitch chat and mess with priority, and if it crashes again, then I'm going to call it. This is the last thing. So goodbye, Firefox. Wow, that cleared up a lot of resources. Firefox was tanking for some reason. And I'm going to start it, and then I'm going to go to Task Manager and change the priority. Last chance, Pokémon Play It. Let's get this working. Okay, where is it? Where's Pokémon Play It? There it is, playit2.exe. Only taking up 13,500 kilobytes. Set priority. Real time. Okay. I've just set Pokémon Play It to the highest priority on my system. Let's see how this works. Okay. This is your last chance, game. Let's make this happen.
Let's play some Pokemon. Make sure you check the text box at the top and the bottom of the screen, and do what it tells you.
Okay, ready? I can follow Let's instructions. Play. Okay. I think this is the fourth time we're doing this. Maybe the fifth. Oh, Doduo, that's new. And a trainer card. I'm going to save them a chop, because I feel like I'm going to get the chance to evolve that. Come on, heads! Yay! Boy, this is just technical difficulties, the video. Okay. I am going to want a Diglett for retreat cheesing. I'm going to want my Machoke. I'm going to want another Machop, because that's probably around the time that Diglett's going to be in trouble. I'll have the energy removal just in case. Oh, hey, nice Mewtwo in the background there. Okay. Flip two coins. Why does he even bother having a button for the coin flip? I just flip the stupid coins.
Huh, that didn't hurt at all. Let's see. Draw a card. I should get some Pokemon on the bench.
No, just you shouldn't. You don't need them. Don't fool yourself.
I'm gonna play a trainer card.
Did she not have any energy? Or is she just waiting to use it? Yeah, failed. What is her hand full of?
Let's see. I can play one energy card per turn.
Okay, she's got one. And she's gonna slap. She's gonna slap my bird. Energy,
and I've done everything else I wanna do.
Oh, I don't slap a bird, it's ungentlemanly. Diglett up. Just go out there automatically. And I'm going to start buffing up my Machop, because I know that Machoke is coming. I knew I couldn't see the chat while streaming anyway. I would have liked to have it open just so I could, like, after the stream go back and see what people are talking about, but
that didn't hurt at all.
Unfortunately, Twitch has a setting for saving chat with videos, but I've never gotten it to work. Like, I look at the VODs and it doesn't save the chat. That, unrelated, but wow, that's a wonky-looking Gengar. Like, all the others are 2D drawings, and they tried to... Did they try to 3D model Gengar? Is that what happened? He looks like he's in the same style as her. Like, they tried to model one of them, realized it looked stupid, and stopped. And just made the others all 2D images. That's my theory about what happened. Oh, Doduo also has no retreat cost. Ow, always the 10 damage. Okay, I'm gonna be able to take one more hit, hopefully. Yeah. And then I will be able to swap out from a choke and wreck that seal. That sounds vaguely like a euphemism. There we go. Okay, I finally got my frickin' Machoke. And it hasn't crashed yet, that's good. Oh yeah, you're gonna get it now. No damage counters. 50 damage. Eat it. Well, she doesn't get any other bench Pokemon. I might win it here if I take out that Staryu. That'd be nice. That'd be nice and fast. I was worried it was going to crash there for a second.
Wow! Knocked out of the arena.
It's straining. I can hear it whirring. I wonder if
I should get some Pokemon on the bench just to get them ready for battle.
Worst case scenario, if it just will not stream at all, I might just have to record offline.
My active Pokemon.
Because I want to get videos of this on the internet. I want people to know about this garbage. Okay, she's got another Staryu now.
Oh yes.
But I got this. I'm a bad, bad man. There we go. Okay. So that's gonna deal 30. And I can take it out without hurting myself. I don't have to use the suicide charge, as is my usual tactic in games.
Wow. Knocked out of the arena! I can't believe it!
Okay. So I think I've got this. I just need to... I've definitely got this. I just need to to wreck this Staryu, and I'm done.
Pokemon has enough energy, and I've done everything else I want to do.
Oh yeah, slap me.
So,
I can take it. Hey, we're actually going to see the end of this battle.
Yes.
I better not have just jinxed it. Okay, just because I can. And then, full body tackle. Yeah, eat it. Eat a dick, Julie. Your modeling is bad and you should feel bad.
Wow, knocked out of the arena. I can't believe it. You beat me. Well, I demand a rematch.
Okay. Hey, it worked. We got to the end of the battle. This real time is actually it's actually going well. I guess Firefox was hogging up the resources. Among other things. So hopefully the stream, hopefully OBS is not taking too much a hit from the resource hogging. We'll have to see how the video turns out.
What's the matter? Are you chicken?
Shut up, Julie!
Who's a Pokemon?
Hopefully the chat is not full of people screaming at me that the stream is crashed or it's like super choppy or anything like that, because that would suck and I would have no way of knowing about it.
Let's play some Pokemon. Make sure you check the text box at the top and the bottom of the screen and do what it tells you. Ready? Let's play.
Okay, we're about an hour and I'm about halfway through the game. So, saving any future crash incidents, I think I'll be able to actually finish this within about a 2-hour stream, a little bit over. So the way I figured out to break the Game Boy version of this game is with Exeggutor. Which I don't know if that's a common strategy with anyone else, but he has a move that you get to flip a coin for every energy card attached to him, and each heads deals 20 damage. So if you just fill your deck with a bunch of like white double colorless energy cards with things designed to pile as many energy cards on him as possible, you can just get huge amounts of damage per turn, and there's just nothing they can do to you. It's pretty bullshit. Is that... I already played an energy, right? Yeah, I did.
Hey, stop cheating.
Headbutt.
Didn't hurt at all. Let's see. Draw a card. Huh, don't need that. I should get some Pokemon on the bench, just to get them ready for battle. Let's see. I can play one energy card per turn, so... my active Pokemon has enough energy, and I've done everything else I want to do, so...
It always worries me when I start hearing the whirring, because I know it's struggling to process that. That abomination.
Yes!
I don't remember how the, I think there are a bunch of, pre-recorded videos that the game just plays as the situation demands. So every time she says something, it has to load a different video file. And otherwise it's just showing a static image of her face. Okay, I got one more turn. I'm gonna attack with Seal, and then I'm gonna surprise and switch out to Sea King.
Huh, that didn't hurt at all.
That's my game plan. Yep, every turn 10 damage.
Cool.
Okay. Gonna do that. I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna kill a bird.
Wow! Knocked out of the arena!
And if she gets another card,
I can't believe it.
That gust of wind might be useful. Okay, this is going better. This is going faster. I'm getting through this.
Let's see. I can play one energy card per turn, so... I think I'll retreat.
Okay.
Meow!
I remember that voice. Oh, you were gonna retreat, are you? No, I don't think you are. I think I'm gonna do this. Yeah, nice try. You're not getting away, Diglett. You will be the next body in my victory pile.
Wow! Knocked out of the arena! I can't believe it.
Right, I'm playing her shitty deck from last time.
Let's
just all
see.
The...
Draw a card.
All the scrawny little water Pokemon.
Let's see. I can play one energy card per turn, so...
Okay, and then he's gonna... Draw a card. I don't remember if Waterfall was a move
Let's
in the
see.
First generation
draw
or not.
Card.
I think it might have been... an attack move that was not tied to any HM. I don't remember for sure, though. There was at least one move like that in Gen 1.
Oh, wow. I'm gonna play a trainer card.
Okay, and then she's gonna retreat, because if she doesn't, she's gonna die this turn.
My active Pokemon is out of here. Gotta pay the retreat cost first.
God, this makes it so tedious, the juggling. I wonder how many of these are from the actual show, like
yes.
Meowth's voice was, and how many of them are just, like, original to the game. Okay, Staryu and... Mostly, Staryu is going to be my next best bet if Sea King does go down. Because he's got the highest attack power.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you look at that face. She knows she's on the fence. She knows she's going down. Yep, that's it.
Oh, yes!
Just because I can. And finish the fight. There we go, beautiful. I love the smell of water Pokemon in the morning.
Wow, knocked out of the arena. I can't believe it.
Okay.
You beat me. I demand a rematch.
Okay, video file... XB427.
Let's play some Pokemon. Make sure you check the text box at the top and the bottom of the screen and do what it tells you. Ready? Let's play. What? Turning off the TV? Hey, wait!
Oh, I can turn her off. That is a very generous feature for them to include in the game. Oh, but she's the best part of the game, though. I can't turn her off completely. I think the yellow one just makes her talk less, which it would also, like, reduce resource use, because every time it... just about every time it crashed was during one of her little video talks.
Well, it's about time you turn that on again.
Ah, shut up.
Let's see. Draw a card.
Yeah, I think the yellow button makes her talk less. So we'll stick to that setting. Come on, Tails! We both win!
Cool!
Okay.
Wow.
I don't notice any less talking happening. Maybe the yellow is that she still talks during fights, but the tutorial stuff is gone? Yeah, no damage. Fuck you. I guess that's how it works. I'm not... Boy, if anyone knew this game existed, I could look it up or something.
Wow.
Considering that it was made by people who probably had no connection and nothing to do with Nintendo, they did a pretty good job. It matches the music is really similar to the style of Pokemon games.
Oh, yes!
Boy, all the ponies. This is my pony deck. I guess I might as well remove it. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna lose this one. For this Ponyta. Anyway, not the game. All the frickin' juggling. Getting old real fast.
I'm gonna play a trainer card.
Oh, you bitch. That's okay. I still got this. I can take her. She can have one victory card. I'm gonna
Knocked
beat you into submission,
arena.
Julie. You hear me? Oh, no, I do. That was dumb of me. I tried to put it on the enemy. Okay. I'm gonna take out that Machop, and that will be no more.
Wow! Knocked out of the arena! I can't believe it!
She's talking just as much! What's the difference between yellow and green? God damn it! Ooh, a Charmander. This is making me want to play the Game Boy version again. The first time I played it, I almost 100%ed it. There were a few, you know, there's RNG. There's
cool.
You open booster packs and you have to grind to get all of the cards in the game. But I came pretty close the first time I played. I was on that game for quite a while. And then, I just kind of trailed off, and I recently, as in within the last, I don't know, 8 months? Sometime in there, I picked it up again. And, I guess I should have been putting those on Ponyta. I didn't get as far that time. I didn't maintain interest, but I think if I were streaming it,
I can't believe it,
I would probably stick to it a bit longer. I don't know how interested people are in Game Boy game streams, though. I was talking for a little while with Jack about doing, like, a dual stream where he was playing one version of Gen 1 Pokemon. And I'm dead. And I was playing another, like we do Red and Blue, and we'd race to see who got to the end or something. And maybe we could composite the videos together and post or something. But that never came to fruition. Well, not yet. It's still a possibility. It might happen. Okay, I'm gonna end this right now. That's what I'm gonna do. There we go. That's a dead Diglett. All right, we're through the basic parts of the game.
Knocked out of the arena.
Maybe the second half will go faster because she'll be talking less. That's what I can hope for, right?
You're pretty impressive. You want to play again?
All right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 8 done, and 7 to go. I think I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna see if I can.
It's
I'm gonna do
to
this
learn
all in one
some
sitting.
Advanced rules. You're totally ready for it.
Okay. So the more tutorial. We're getting in advanced rules now. There's gonna be some like secret tech that you're gonna hear about here and nowhere else. Like, this is not known to the general Pokémon trading card game community. It's gonna be like those special rules in chess where you can, like, switch the king and the knight at the start of a battle or something. Where the hell did those come from?
This is pretty bad for you.
Okay, we're learning about weakness now. Yeah, there are some, There's some weird chess technicalities.
To all fighting Pokemon, put your cursor on Rattata, and I'll show you. See here, Rattata is weak to all attacks from fighting Pokemon. That means when Diglett attacks, Rattata will take double damage, like this.
Weird, weird chess rules of
Rattata
just unknown origin
damage from the
that are really specific.
Only 10. Put your cursor on top of the marker to see the explanation for weakness. See what it says? Weak Pokemon take double damage. Ouch! You'd better do something, or it's lights out for you and Rattata.
I was never interested in the game, but I was in a chess club in elementary school. Mostly because I had to be in a club, and the school had very, 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 very few clubs. Okay, if that Rattata dies, I'm dead. So I know they're gonna make me retreat.
Good move. Doduo is way better than Rattata against fighting Pokemon. See
new
marker next to Doduo this time? Doduo is totally resistant to the attacks of fighting Pokemon. That means Doduo takes less damage every time it's attacked by a fighting Pokemon. In fact, it takes 30 less damage each time. Put your cursor on Doduo to see here. It shows the resistance.
Did she just
Doduo
cut herself
weakness
off?
And resistance are an important part of the game. Watch out for them.
Okay, now I can do something. I'm immune to fighting. There are some weird weird interactions in Pokemon between types. Oh. Like, the thing with bird, with flying type being resistant to fighting is because, like, they're flying and thus hard to hit, right? That's the logic? Except Doduo is a land bird, so that doesn't really apply, right?
Diglett attacked with the Mud Slap for 30. But Doduo's fighting resistance took away 30 damage. So Diglett did nothing. Zero. Oh, man. I'm in trouble in this game.
Another thing that always seemed really stupid is how the logic that water is weak to electric because, you know, water conducts electricity. But steel, which conducts electricity much better than water, is not weak to electric. In fact, I think steel might be resistant to electric. I don't remember exactly. Maybe it's neutral. I think it's neutral. I might as well. Watch, next turn I'm going to get a Dodrio. And I'm going to need like 3 energy cards. I'm going to have wasted that energy. Diglett is trying to retreat. Oh, you bitch. Yeah, I'm resistant. Well, now this is just sad. They can't touch me. Is she gonna get a Dodrio or something? Okay, I can heal my Rattata.
Click on the Pokemon you want to heal. Are you sure you want to put more energy on that Pokemon?
Shut up, I might get a Dodrio. Don't tell me how to play. I'm gonna kick your ass. With my RNG. couple of lucky rolls. Yeah, yeah, try your hardest. Mole cannot touch bird.
Are you sure?
Shut up, Julie! There we go. Okay. Maybe I'm just programmed in this event to get all double heads. That might be it.
Looks like you won. My fighting Pokemon just couldn't do anything to Doduo. Click on the return button.
Okay. Jigglypuff event. I like Jigglypuff. The only one able to slay the mighty Puff. Puff the Charizard, that is. From Smash. That Gengar looks so weird still.
There's no chance for you this time. I built a new deck. My new deck is called Sleep Tight. You'll see why in a sec.
I wonder. Oh, right, we haven't done any status effect stuff. Guess we're getting into that now, these advanced techniques. Again, top secret stuff. Don't mention it to other Pokemon playing card game players.
When playing with
only people who see this video are allowed to know about it.
In your hand. Don't lay them on the table, silly.
I get it, Julie. Shut up.
Oh, hey. One new rule I should mention.
Oh, new rule.
You just put Pokemon into the arena to start the game. But if you want to, you can take any other Pokemon in your hand and place them on the bench right now, before the game starts. When you're finished, just click on the done button.
Oh, right. I forgot about that rule.
Good. I don't have any more Pokemon in my hand.
By the way, one more new rule. This is like Yu-Gi-Oh! All over again. Pegasus making up bullshit rules for the Duelist Kingdom. The field is covered in water, so it conducts summon Skull's electricity attacks.
Oh, okay, your turn. Jigglypuff.
The moon card affects the tides of the actual ocean.
It's pretty tough. Check out its lullaby attack when you get a chance.
Okay, that'll come in handy. In addition to the trading card game, I also may kind of found a way to break Gen 1 of Pokemon. Oh, no. No, no, no. Don't do it. We lost it. We lost it, Murph. It's gone. Call it. Time of death. 4:53 p.m. We were doing so well, too. We made so much progress. I think we can keep going. I think that was a rare crash. They're not happening very often anymore. I think we can put up with them. I think we can, right, that was still at the start of the battle. We can jump back into that. I am determined. Ash Ketchum does not give up. He's not a quitter.
Oh, back for more, huh? There's no chance for you this
is
time.
Does she know?
I built a new deck.
Does she know she's crashing me? Back for more, huh?
You'll see why in a sec.
Like, she knows she's not gonna beat me at the game, so she's trying to kick me out of it. She's flipping the chessboard, is what she's doing.
Oh, hey. One new rule I should mention.
Okay, I know about your rule.
Into the arena to start the game, but if you want to, you can take.
Can I skip
any
it? Can I do my thing now? No, I gotta wait for her to finish
right
talking.
Now, before the game starts, when you're finished, just click on the done button.
Okay,
good.
Done.
I don't have any more Pokemon in my hand, so nothing to the bench for me. Oh, okay, your turn. Jigglypuff and Goldeen. All right, Jigglypuff is pretty tough.
Let me
check
move.
Out lullaby attack when you get a chance.
Okay, there we go. Attack. I I just realized she's not on the screen. I guess for the tutorial ones, she doesn't appear.
Oh, yeah, there it is. Your active Pokémon is now asleep. The lullaby attack makes the defending Pokémon go to sleep. It's pretty tough. Put your cursor on top of the sleep marker to see what I mean. See? A Pokémon that's asleep can't attack or retreat.
Yeah.
But at the end of every turn, you get to flip a coin. Heads, the Pokémon wakes up and goes back to normal. Tails, and the Pokémon keeps on napping. Some trainer cards will help a Pokémon wake up. Look for them. Oh, yeah. If the sleeping Pokémon evolves or somehow gets back to the bench, it'll wake up then, too. So my turn is over. Go ahead and flip a coin to see if your Pokémon wakes up. Remember, you get to flip a coin at the end of every turn, not just at the end of your turn.
Yakka yakka ya. Oi, the noise on this one.
Tails, you're
always with the talking.
Is still sleeping.
That'll do. That'll do just fine.
Good. Goldeen wakes up and evolves. You're playing really well.
Yeah, you know it. I'm gonna kick Jigglypuff's ass. I'm gonna finish this. I'm in a race to complete this game before it destroys itself by crashing. You can't keep me down. It's not gonna happen.
Good play. Full Heal is a great trainer card. Your Pokémon is awake now.
There we go. That's one more tutorial done with.
Oh well. Too bad for Jigglypuff. I just didn't get any more Pokémon into my hand. I guess that happens sometimes. Click on the return button to go back to the gymnasium.
Okay, so it looks like the challenge ones are the actual games. The games. And the ones that aren't listed as challenges are the tutorials. So only 4 actual games available to play. And only one of them that features all of the game's features.
Oh man, that last game was pretty close. You're getting better.
Well, this time,
I've got a good fire deck. Let's see you win this game.
I don't remember it being close at all. I remember you singing a song while I punched you in the face repeatedly. Lots of trainer cards.
Remember, when playing with real cards, don't let your opponent see the cards in your hand.
Yeah, you've mentioned this several times. Am I gonna get a Dragonite? That'd be pretty cool. I want a Dragonite. I don't think I'm going to get a Dragonite.
Ha ha! Tails.
Oh fuck you! Volt, I think I will. Might get a Dragonair. That might
be sure to take out your Dragon Pokemon.
I think I remember that in this event.
Oh, I can't attack yet. Vulpix needs one more energy.
Oh, confusion this time.
It's your turn.
Okay, going to pound. Gotta pound this fox. This comment approved by Fred McPain.
Now I can attack. The attack for Vulpix is called Confuse Ray. I get to flip a coin when Vulpix attacks with Confuse Ray.
Sitting a little awkwardly here. We have a coffee table that pulls out and, like, becomes a normal table.
Heads.
But
not only did
it doesn't pull out far enough
damage,
to act to, like, comfortably
confused
sit at the couch and use
like
it.
Sleep. It's a special advanced
I could move
rule.
It closer to the couch,
put
but then there's not enough
the
room for the
to see what I mean.
The couch to, you know, recline to put the footrest out.
If Dratini tries to
which is much more important.
Or retreat, you have to flip a coin first. If you attack and it's tails, Dratini attacks itself for 20 damage. Man, that's
tough.
Oh, I
don't want to attack myself. Oh, I'm getting my own status effects. Okay, I'm gonna attack anyway, that's what I'm gonna do. Well, maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I should just end it. Oh, I don't know if it's programmed to hurt myself if I try to attack. I think it might be. So I'm gonna do nothing. I'm gonna tank this turn, and I'm gonna switch to Paris next turn.
You should have attacked.
Oh, shut up!
Pokemon had enough energy. How come you didn't?
Because I'm confused. Oh, does it also when it tries to retreat? Oh, yeah, it has to do a thing when it tries to retreat, too. Okay. I'll do the Paris. It's weak to fire, but I can make it work.
Switch is a great trainer card when your Pokemon is confused. Switch lets you bench your Pokemon automatically.
I know what
even
Switch does.
Confused, or asleep, or anything.
Stop talking, Julie. I don't care if I'm weak. I'm gonna put you to sleep, and then I'm gonna attack you. That's what I'm gonna do. I guess I could heal the, Now, I'll save my, I'm gonna save my potions for Parasect.
Oh, now my Pokemon is asleep. Hopefully it'll wake up soon.
Hopefully it won't. God damn it! I'm confused now. Just chugging along. Oh, right, it's flip a coin and it's confused. But she's just winning all the coin flips. Okay. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do this. And do I want to, do that? Do I care? It's just gonna retreat if I do. Is it worth getting the hit on Doduo? I don't know if it is or not. Ah, fuck it. I'm gonna go for it. I've got another potion left.
Okay, since your Pokemon is...
Don't hit myself. God damn it! Oh, okay, good.
But your Pokemon is still confused. Confused.
Oh, whatever.
Confused.
Oh no.
Confused.
Oh no.
Confused. 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 Confused.
Polymerization.
Confused. Confused. Confused.
Confused. Confused. Confused.
Confused. Confused. Confused. Confused. Confused. Confused.
I'm just gonna have to. I could put like a technical difficulties between each of these, but I think I'll just leave them in. I think. Thank God the game is fast to start.
Oh man, that last game was pretty close.
Oh, I can skip her. Boy, I'm just discovering new conveniences all the time in this. Okay. Maybe this will go a little bit better.
Vulpix.
Oh, I'm gonna have to hear the stupid confusion explanation again, though.
Be sure to take out your dragon Pokemon. Oh, I can't attack yet. Vulpix needs one more energy. Huh. Okay, it's your turn.
Okay, gonna do the thing I did the last time, and I'm gonna... Things are gonna go about the same way. I set this program to real time and it's
now I can
still struggling
the attack
to.
The Vulpix is called Confuse Ray. I get to flip a coin when Vulpix attacks with Confuse Ray.
Still struggling to allocate the resources. And it's gonna confuse because otherwise you wouldn't be able to tell me about how confusion works.
Heads! Not only did Dratini take
now you're
10
gonna
damage,
tell me to put my cursor on
confused.
The confusion marker.
Confuse is kind of like sleep. It's a special advanced rule. Put your
advanced.
Cursor on top of the confuse marker.
It's on the
to
confused
see what I mean.
Thing now.
If Dratini tries to attack,
give your
or
spiel.
Retreat, you have to flip a coin first. If you attack and it's tails, Dratini attacks itself for 20 damage. Man, that's tough.
I know there are different ways to signify that a Pokemon is under a certain status effect. I don't remember what paralyzed is. I think there's a paralyzed in this game, isn't there? Maybe there's not. I don't remember. If there is, I'm sure I'll find out about it pretty soon. Okay, she wants me to attack. I'm going to attack.
Okay, since your Poke... Tails. Ow, your Pokemon attacks itself for 20 damage.
And then I
and
lose the
like
Dratini.
Normal, your turn is over after you attack.
Okay. Well, I did nothing the last time, and she yelled at me for not attacking, so now I just lost. God damn it. I lost a fucking tutorial.
Oh, well. It was a tough game. Try it again. Use those trainer cards to your best advantage.
Gotta go through this shit again.
Ready to go again? All right.
Well, she just doesn't know what she wants. It would be cool to see this with, I like the layout of this. It's got a really, really nice, really intuitive user interface. And I would love to see this with more,
Vulpix versus
I would have liked to see this as an
My
actual game.
Pokemon is sure to take out your dragon Pokemon.
Whether it be, like, single player, like the Game Boy version, or, even the online version.
Oh,
which,
I can't
the online
yet.
Pokemon trading
Vulpix
card game is really bad with resource
energy.
Use.
Huh. Okay, it's your turn.
And I had a lot of slowdown trying to play that game during the period I was playing it. So.
Now
and also, I don't
attack.
Remember it being the most,
is called
the most intuitive layout in the world. It'd be cool to see something like this for
Ray.
More than just this tutorial kind of game. I wonder, there have to be other people who remember this, who got this with their first, like, pack
Heads.
Of Pokemon trading cards.
Not only did Dratini take 10 damage, but now it's confused. Confused.
Like, there are going to be a bunch
sleep.
Of people who see the YouTube
it's
video about this, and they're like,
rule.
I remember
Put
this! Holy crap, other people know this exists?
You see what I mean. If Dratini tries to attack or retreat,
I mean, I guess it
first.
Did the job.
You attack, and it's tails.
Pokemon
Dratini
trading cards were a huge thing for a while.
For 20 damage. Man, that's tough.
Okay, I'm not going to attack this time. And she's going to yell at me for it, but I'm still not going to do it. I guess I could use the potion and then attack, but why would I waste the potion on 10?
Hey, you should have attacked.
Shut up, Julie.
Pokemon had enough energy. How come you didn't?
Because I've been down that alternate reality before. I know exactly what happens. Okay. I'm gonna do the thing that I was doing last time. Not before the game crashed. That seemed like it was going pretty well.
Switch is a great trainer card when your Pokemon.
I know it's a great trainer card. That's why
Switch
I used it.
You bench your Pokemon automatically, even if it's confused or asleep or anything.
Well, they got enough "Shut Up, Julie" buttons in this game, but they don't have a universal one. Okay, now I'm gonna use Spore. I guess if I wanted to, I could have used Dratini to tank one more turn, and I have enough for, I'd have enough for Slash.
Oh, no, my Pokemon is asleep. Hopefully it'll wake up soon.
Okay, good. So that is actually random. It's not scripted that Vulpix will always wake up immediately. Okay, if I go to the Doduo, it's just gonna retreat, so I'm going to, I am going to attack the Vulpix with my, Leaf Laser Beam attack. I don't know if you were aware that, Pokemon had those, but... Okay, that's okay, I can take the double damage. Oh, and I'm confused, goddammit. Okay, I don't get a full heal. I'm gonna use this. I'm going to attack and hope the confusion...
Okay, since your Pokemon is confused...
Oh, this is the first time I'm doing it. Okay, good.
Successful, but your Pokemon is still confused.
Yeah, whatever. Doesn't matter. I win. Screw you, Julie. Oh, I'm glad that wasn't scripted to always hit myself on the first use to show off what confusion is.
You win. Good job. You're really becoming a great trainer. I thought it would win with Vulpix for sure. Click on the return button.
Okay, we're making progress. It's the
good
crash...
Good job. You've earned a badge for your efforts.
She is determined to prevent my progress with the crashing, but... I am more determined to make it through this fucking game.
You know, you've won quite a few ribbons. I'm beginning to think you're not a bad player after
ribbons.
All.
I thought they were badges.
But now, I've got Pikachu coming up.
There was a Pokemon board game that I remember. I don't think I ever actually played it how it was supposed to be played, but I remember it looking pretty cool. I would have liked to have been able to play it. Like, not a physical board game, not like a digital video game board game. Though Pokemon Mario Party, I'd be willing to give that a shot if just for the novelty as well. I had Pokemon Channel on the GameCube.
Pikachu versus Weedle.
Didn't do much with that. I never played it much. I think actually my brother had that. And it was technically his, which is why I don't have it anymore in my GameCube collection. Okay, we got a poison mechanic now. Leaf Laser!
Oh, man. I forgot all about Weedle and its poison sting. Now you get to flip a coin. If it's heads, Pikachu will be poisoned. Oh, darn. Pikachu got poisoned. Put your cursor on the poison marker and take a look at what it does.
It's on the poison marker.
See what it says? Now Pikachu takes 10 damage at the end of every turn. If Pikachu retreats or evolves, then of course the poison effect will end. But until then, Pikachu's gonna take damage every turn. Your turn ends, so Pikachu takes 10 damage from the poison.
Okay, so potentially a 20 damage attack on the first turn. Okay, if that gets another energy card, that's going to fuck
me. My turn's over now. And Pikachu takes another 10 damage. Any more of this, and I'm in trouble.
Okay, I could switch out the Pikachus. Or... I'm just gonna use the potion. So that... Otherwise, she's gonna get another energy card next turn... And she's going to deal 30 damage to me, and I'm going to lose. And I don't want that to happen. I do not want to lose. I do not want to lose game to Julie. She is half machine, half pussy.
This is kind of interesting. Even though you got heads, Pikachu isn't poisoned a second time. Because Pikachu is already poisoned.
Can't stack a DOT in this game. That pussy thing is from Hardcore Henry, which Jack made me watch recently. Oh, you think you're safe, do you, Pikachu? Well, I got news. I got news for you, son. Pikachu! Yeah, what an adorable voice to kill. What? Why? It's dead! Why do I care if the corpse is poisoned or not? I think that oversights like that were addressed in the Pokémon Trading Card Game online. Like, if it's dead anyway, it's not gonna ask you to flip a coin to see if it's poisoned.
How knocked out! Man! Weedle! That poison ability is pretty tough!
Okay, yeah, there is a paralyzed status effect in this game. There's not a frozen status effect. I think anything that would freeze just paralyzes. And I don't remember how paralysis works. I'm guessing I'm gonna find out this time. These advanced ones are just going through all the status effects, it seems like.
I am so ready for you this game. Don't forget, you can put Pokemon on your bench here in the beginning of the game. That is, if you wanna.
Well, maybe I don't want to. I'd rather be alone. Ooh, pincer. Two pincers. Yep, I see paralysis. So we're at the point where they're not entirely scripted. They're not just like pure quick time, like the first couple of tutorials were.
You have Pinsir in your deck? Well, good thing I brought Tangela to the arena. This should be a good battle.
Okay, both paralysis and poison. If this were an actual match, this would be so incredibly tedious. I wonder what happens if I just... if I do the double colorless first. I guess there wouldn't be any point to that. I'm gonna need the double grass anyway. I wonder if she would yell at me for that. I guess I could have built up my other pincer and used the switch. That probably would have been the best thing to do in this scenario. Ah, shit. Whatever. I'm committed now.
Your active Pokemon can attack now. It doesn't have enough energy.
Yeah, it's not what I wanted to do. Now I'm going to get paralyzed. Yep. Heads, because it's got to show off the paralyzing.
Yeah, now Pinsir is paralyzed. That means it can't attack or retreat during your next turn.
Okay, so
put your cursor on the paralyzed
paralysis is a one-turn event.
Pinsir is paralyzed all the way through to the end of your next turn.
You know, to allow stun locking. Okay, so if I get paralyzed, I'm fucked, and if not, poison powder. Okay, I'm fine. I'm golden. Tangela is going to die.
Go, Tangela.
Paralyzed, poisoned, whatever. Brute force. There we go. All good. I win. Julie loses.
Man, he won again. Pinsir is definitely a good basic Pokemon. Click on the return button.
Okay. Okay, last tutorial. We're at the home stretch. We're at the end of this thing. It's just this and the final battle. The boss battle with Julie. You gotta take down the tyrant once and for all.
Before you win the trophy, I better watch out.
Oh, I'm gonna get a trophy. Well, that'll be just fine. Put it up in my room, nice and shiny. Better print it out and put it on my fridge. Okay, is this showing off double colorless, I'm guessing? Even though they've appeared in previous matches?
Koffing versus Rattata this time. Koffing is one of the best. Rattata's on the way out.
Oh, is Koffing the best? Is that what that is?
Well, Koffing can't attack until next turn. Not enough energy.
That is a pretty nasty move. I'll give her that. Okay. Oh, look, I happen to draw
Snorlax.
A counter.
Oh, wow. That's a great basic Pokemon. Take a look at Snorlax. See the red text? Snorlax has a Pokemon power.
Oh, it's Pokemon
Some
powers.
Some of the really cool Pokemon have powers. The powers are in effect almost all the time. You gotta read them. Because of its Pokemon power, Snorlax cannot become poisoned, asleep, confused, or paralyzed. It's totally cool. Man, I wish I had a Snorlax.
Okay, so now I bulk up Snorlax, I feed him lots of energy. I guess I might as well just switch him out now. He's got 90 hit points, what's she gonna do to me? That's what a Snorlax with gas sounds like. Ow. Your leaf laser tickles.
Well, Koffing is almost useless against Snorlax. It still does 10 damage, but the confuse and poison part of the attack don't do a thing.
Okay, there we go. Time to use my fat attack. Snorlax actually knows a metronome in Pokémon Stadium on the N64. I think the rental Snorlax on one of the levels does. And it's pretty amazing. At one point, I got it to use, It used fly, and it just started floating up into the air. It was a pretty fantastic thing, and I wish I had it recorded. That would have been pretty cool. Just piling on the damage. Stop your stalling. Worse than Raylan, this one. Okay. Just so I can say I won without any damage. It would have been a kick in the teeth if that potion crashed the game. That one final fuck you from Julie. When do I get to see that kid from the intro, the fake Ash Ketchum? Is he going to appear?
Good job.
Is he the final boss? Do I get to fight him?
Right.
Him and his
for another game.
Him and his deep
Click on
one mouth.
Button.
Okay, the final one. This is it. Uh-oh. Okay, it's a video happening.
Wow, you beat me in every single game. You're the best. Now you can play against me in the advanced games, too. Just click on the new trophy, and there's a whole bunch of decks to choose from in there.
Oh, okay, so this is the actual... This is the game.
Let's play some Pokemon. Make sure you check the text box at the top and the bottom of the screen, and do what it tells you. Ready? Let's play.
Okay, so there's a variety of decks that I could, that I can use on this. DK Dark Charizard? Interesting. I think I'll go with the psychic one just for... Oh, are there more over there? Oh yeah, there's a Wet and Wild. Pokemon Gone Wild. Alright, I'll go with the psychic slash colorless one. I'm not gonna... If I really wanted to squeeze everything out of this game, I could do a game with every deck, but I am not doing that right now. Or probably ever. But if you were to want to... Okay, do I want to... I want Jigglypuff, or do I want... I'll do Lickitung at first. He's a good starter to have. But... No, if I wanted to actually... If this was, like, the only version of the trading card game that I had, and I wanted to actually, you know, play the trading card game, this is the only way I could do it, because it's not scripted, or it doesn't have any special events or anything like that, and I could choose from a variety of decks, so... This is the closest thing in the game to an actual free choose-your-own-deck-and-play-how-you-want game. So,
that didn't hurt at all.
Or I guess the better way to say it is that this is the only part of the game that has any replay value, though it's not much.
Let's see. Draw a card.
So I'll do this once. And I'll look around some of the other things on the main menu that we skipped. Not going to spend any significant amount of time with them.
Cool.
And then I'm gonna end this stream. I might do some Awesome Knots after this. I might move on to some of that. Okay, do I want Confuse? Do I care? I guess I could Confuse. Yeah, I might as well. Oh, I gotta flip a coin, though. Okay, good. I'm gonna take out the most powerful one early.
Let's see. Draw a card.
See, there's some actual... This is a full six-card game. This one could actually be something of a challenge. Oh, she's trying to retreat. Fail. Fail. Yes! Wasted two energy cards. This is good. Oh, I got two Dragonairs, nothing to evolve it. I need a Dratini. Okay, this is going well, for now. This is a full six-card game. I'm gonna be able to finish this with Julie. Paralyzed and confused. I'm getting lucky this time around. Oh, wait, that overwrote the confusion? God damn it. Oh, that's stupid. Well, what was the point of me confusing it then? I wasn't going to be able to do anything after that. I guess I can confuse it again next time. To try to prevent its, try to prevent a retreat again. But no, if it wants to retreat, it's going to do so this next turn, right? Oh, she doesn't have any energy cards. Oh, that's too bad, Julie. I guess I'm just going to have to keep beating on you. Just 10 more for each damage counter on the defending Pokemon. Okay. Well, too bad I don't have any energy cards, or that might be, you know, useful. Guess I'm just going to keep licking. Licky, licky, lick. Julie, your tears are so delicious.
That didn't hurt at all.
Still no energy. Po Lapras. I wonder if I would get more... Nah, it's gonna average the same if I confuse it and just do nothing. And it's got... Lickitung has a huge retreat cost, so it's not worth it trying to switch out at all. Man, I picked a low attack power Pokemon, though. This is getting tedious. now she's going to retreat. No, she's not. But she didn't... Oh, she did use Confuse Ray. Okay.
Come on, heads!
Come on, tails! God damn it. Oh, that ain't good. Okay. Here's what I'm going to do. I am going to, I'm going to leave that Jinx alone. I only need one Jinx is plenty. I'm going to hope I get lucky. I'm going to hope I get two heads. I'm going to try and confuse the Lapras, and then I'm going to not attack. Yes! Wow, I'm getting lucky. 25% chance of that.
I'm going to play a trainer card.
Oh, this is a long match, though, so... I'm trying to retreat. Oh, come on, fail. Please fail. Run out of energy.
Come on, heads!
Use all your energy cards. Oh. That's okay. She's got no energy. Can't do anything. Do I want to... I think I want to up my Jinx. I think that's going to be... the next. Jinx or Jigglypuff are good picks. Oh, do I want to keep trying with Lickitung? It's not going to take any damage if I don't do anything, so I have to do something. I think Supersonic is the better investment here. Oh, it's just going to retreat if I do that, though. Maybe I should have done the tongue attack. Yeah. Oh, she's still got to do the coin flip, though. God damn it. I'm getting lucky with the... with the Supersonic, but it's not doing anything, because she's not... I guess she doesn't have any energy to attack with, so I guess... Oh, okay, there we go, finally. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm just gonna... Because it can attack, and thus... Confusion is pretty useless. I'm gonna go for the, I'm gonna go for the Lick Attack, and if Lickitung knocks itself out, oh well. That means I can finally use a different Pokemon. Okay. I'm probably running low on energy myself here, but at this point, if I try to start committing to a Dragonair, I want to get my Jinx up and running at the very least. Yeah, fuck it. Oh, okay, Lickitung's out. That ain't great. Well, I guess it's not bad either, though. I can finally do some damage.
Knocked out of the arena.
Yeah, shut up, Julie.
Jeez.
Oh, that was sexy. This was before the whole blackface controversy. It's already got the purple tint to it. I guess that's just an effect of the card, though. Can I move him? God, OCD doesn't like having that space there. It's really annoying. Okay, I'm gonna start beefing up that Dratini there. Okay, I might as well. Meditate does the maximum amount of damage the Double Slap could do, so there's no reason not to use it. Weird that Meditate is a damage-dealing attack, though. I miss the early days of Pokemon. At a simpler time. Only 151 species.
Cool!
Okay, energy? No, energy removal, okay. She's just gonna... Energy removal's not gonna do anything to... I wanted to say Gohan to Goldeen. She's just gonna retreat again. I'm talking tactics like it matters in this game.
I'll live. Aha! Check this out.
Oh, don't evolve. Oh! God damn it. I should have done the energy removal.
Yes!
There we go. Okay, no retreating for you. There we go. Gonna do a nice hard hit. Still need one more hit, though.
Oh, wow. Let's see. Draw a card.
Gonna Jinx the damage dealer. The snowballer Jinx. I almost want to put that Jinx out there just so that whole... Fuck it, I'm putting that Jinx out there. There, oh, that's so much better. I'm gonna need one more energy before I can use the Dragonair effectively, though, so... Taking out Sea King. Dot, dot, dot. Can't fit all the damage.
Wow, knocked out of the arena.
Okay, who are you gonna put out? She's mana starved. I've mana drained her. Oh, if I hit him, that's gonna make Flail strong. It can wait. It's gonna be 10 times the number of damage counters, so I want that to be 1. I think I'm actually gonna use Double Slap first on this one. And hope I don't get the 25% chance of 2 tails, because that would suck. That's not what I wanted either. Okay, so he's gonna... Well, 20
Let's
damage
see.
Isn't
Draw
much.
A card.
That's fine. I can take it. Oh, don't retreat. You... Oh, you bitch. At least Lapras is also a weak
yes.
attacker. Like, look, that's what held the game up at the start, is because Lapras has no attack power, and Lickitung had no attack power, so it's just too... Big bulky dudes with no muscle power slapping each. It's two fat guys having a slap fight. Okay, I mean, Dratini's getting there. Alright. Doing okay. My threat at this point is the game crashing. As long as that doesn't happen, we're good. She's just got so many Pokemon to juggle, though. Okay, there we go. That's a good. That's a nice, fully stocked Dragonair. If Jinx goes down, I have something ready in the wings. I always liked having a Dratini in my party in the first two
yes.
Pokemon games. Try to get that as early as possible because it takes so long to get a Dragonite. That it's just, it makes things easier if you train it over the course of the game. Okay, I think I want another Jinx. I think that's what I'm gonna work on. Because Jinx is a slow to get starting, but she once she starts, Jinx in this game is Isla in Awesome Knots. Gotta start
wow.
the snowball.
Knocked out of the arena. I can't believe it.
Which I am planning to switch to some Awesome Knots after this. I think I'm gonna keep streaming a little while, so expect that coming up. Okay, I'm getting lots of energy. That's good. I enjoy energy. Okay, there we go. That's one more down. I'm moving through this. I got my things started up. My mana is built, and I am tearing through these.
Wow! Knocked out
again.
The arena.
Biggest threat is the game crashing. In which case, I'm gonna call. I'm not gonna worry about clearing this optional event. That's just really for fun. You don't win anything from it. I think maybe you get access to some stickers you can print off or something. But this, we're almost done with this. Just tearing through the ranks. How's that juggling paying off for you now, huh? Julie the Juggler.
Wow, knocked out of the arena. I can't believe it.
Okay.
Seal.
Let's see. Draw a card.
Okay, so he's gonna take two hits. Some potions would be nice now.
Yes.
Ooh. Do the wave. So now I put another thing on the bench there. And I have a souped up Wigglytuff. Actually, I might send her next instead of Dragonair. Cause that would be a 660 damage per hit with a full bench. Maybe. In fact. Yeah, fuck it. Damage. All the damage. Why wait for more damage? The voice of a monster right there. Oh, one hit kill. Fuck you, Seal. I'm gonna take out everything you have in one hit.
Wow. Knocked out of the arena.
Fear the Wigglytuff. That Dratini looks so sad. Oh, it's heartrending. What is that R? Is that like a Team Rocket Dratini? Is it being abused? Tales from the Dratini Diary. Okay. Yeah, that's game. Bye-bye, Julie, and good riddance. I'll never have to look at your beautiful face again. I'll never get to until I go to Rule 34 and see all of the porn.
Well, I demand a rematch.
Because it's in such high demand. No, I don't want to play again. I'm done. Okay, before I close out of this, I'm going to look around just a little bit, because I remember there were other things in this game. Oh, well, you get like CG images of Julie, full body poses. That's too much for me. I can print lists of cards that I have and the ones that I need. This is such a nerd engine. Oh, it's whirring, it's struggling.
Welcome to the card collector. Click on the box below each card to keep track of your collection. And you can click on each card to hear the battle cry. Oh, use the buttons on the left to sort through all the different cards. And hurry it up. I'm ready to play you in a new game.
That's kind of cool. I didn't know it did the battle cry for all of them. So, it's got all the cards in the game. And I can sort them by sets or by type or any of that. So it is a neat little collector program, I guess. This would be neat to have when the card game had just come out, and people were trying to catch them all, as it were. Again, it's nice that the music actually matches the Pokemon style pretty well. Also, these all look, you can all tell these are taken from totally unrelated parts of the anime. Like, look how low-def that Exeggutor is compared to, like, the Jigglypuff and Clefairy. Oh, it's beautiful.
Welcome to the Deck Builder. What would you like to do?
Oh, there's a tutorial. I can learn how to build decks.
All right, let's learn how to build a deck. You know, water cards are my favorite, but I got bored and started building a grass deck instead. I need your help to finish it. Ready? Let's look at the deck I started. It's here, in the bottom half of the screen.
Okay.
I called this deck the Venom Deck, because there's some cool poison Pokémon in it, and that's a good strategy for deck building. Check it out.
Okay, so you can make your own decks, is what I'm getting out of this. I don't think you can use them in the, maybe you can use them in the trophy match.
When you're done reading the strategy tip,
shut up, Julie! I don't know if you can use them in the trophy event. It'd be cool if you could. You'd build your own decks and actually use them in the game.
Welcome to the help menu.
Okay, now I've been through all this. I don't. What's a Pokemon? Okay, it's struggling to answer my question. Oh, there are videos.
Hey, how's it going? This is a Pokemon card. One Pokemon from the coolest card game ever made.
Oh, is it? That's a bold claim.
All right, let's go look at Dugtrio, who evolves from Diglett.
Never did see a Dugtrio.
So, now that you've seen Diglett, a basic Pokemon, let's look at an evolved
I still don't
Pokemon.
Know what a Pokemon is. Dugtrio. Am I supposed to? What's a Pokemon, Julie?
You can tell that Dugtrio is an evolved Pokemon.
Those 3D graphics on some of the cards always look so weird.
It even tells you who Dugtrio evolved.
Okay, we know all this. In case the physical tutorial, for those of you who learn by reading rather than doing. Make your own coin. Join the Pokemon League. That was a cool thing back in the late 90s. I think this is just probably a link to a now absent website is what I'm going to assume. But yeah, so that was Pokemon Play It, the game disc that came as a tutorial when the Pokemon Trading Card Game was first released. Made for Windows 95, somehow I got it to work on this, and we made it through the entire quote-unquote game with the lovely, lovely, lovely Julie, who I'm sure you will all remember for minutes to come. So, let's see what this is. Oh, there's a full credits roll. I'm gonna call it for this video. I might grab something real quick and small to snack on, and then I'm going to be back in probably about 10 minutes or so with Awesome Knots. I'm going to do a bit of Awesome Knots tonight. Julie character. Scott Rodenheiser, you poor, poor bastard. Debbie Rogers was the voice. I don't recognize anyone. It would be cool if it was actually someone I recognized from, I think NYAV Post was the dubbing studio that did most of the voices for kids stuff, including the early, you know, the early... Hasbro Interactive, they don't need to be tied to this. Why are they tied to Hasbro? You did Roller Coaster Tycoon, you're better than this. Granted, the AI in this game is better than Roller Coaster Tycoons, but still... Thank you for watching all the credits. Oh, I get a little thank you, because I watched the credits. Alright, I'm going to call it for now. I'll be back in just a little bit with some Awesome Knots. And I'll be able to look at the chat. See you guys soon.